You can follow along and make observations as we create a model of how water flows across the land, or make a model of your own. You will need 2 plain white pieces of paper, tape, any kind will work, a blue washable marker, and a spray bottle filled up with water. And that's it. Take 1 piece of white paper and crumple it up into a ball, trying to get it full of wrinkles. You can then smooth it back out to make sure that it has plenty of texture. You don't want a flat piece of paper, or the model won't have much to observe. If the paper needs crumpled again, go for it. Smooth it back out again, almost all the way. It should still be a little bit crumpled, showing small ridges, high points, and valleys, low points. Imagine the paper is a model of a section of land and find the ridge lines. These are the tops of the fold lines. Use a washable blue marker, not permanent, to color along the ridge lines of the land. Make sure to boldly color every single one of the ridge lines. Have you ever been high up on a hill or a mountain? What could you see from the top? What do you think you could see from the tops of these ridge lines? Once you have colored all of your ridge lines blue, you're ready for the next step. Take your second piece of paper and tape each corner of the land onto the other piece of paper and the table to help it stay put. Before we put our model into action, let's think about what happens to rainwater after it falls. Where does the rainwater go? We are going to make it rain on our model by using the spray bottle. What do you think will happen to the land when it rains? What will happen to the blue ridge lines once the water drops on them? As you begin to spray, and the water moves across the land, what do you see or notice? What do you wonder? What does it remind you of? Have you seen something like this before? As you spray and the water moves, how did the rainfall travel or move across the land? How did it move like you expected? How did it move differently? What do you notice about the places where water has collected? Where do we see water collect in nature? Human beings can change a watershed in good ways and not so good ways by the choices we make in our watershed. You can follow along and make observations as we create a model of how humans change their watershed or make a model of your own. You will need 2 sheets of plain white paper, red washable marker, blue washable marker, tape, any kind will do, and a spray bottle filled with water. Take 1 piece of white paper and crumple it up into a ball, trying to get it full of wrinkles just like before. Smooth it back out to make sure that it has plenty of texture. If the paper needs crumpled again, go for it. Smooth it back out again, almost all the way. It should still be a bit crumpled, again showing small ridges, high points, and valleys, low points. Imagine the paper is a model of a section of land, and remember your observations of where the water traveled from the ridges downhill through the valleys and collected in the low points of our last model. Use your washable blue marker to follow the path that water would travel from high to low in the watershed, based on your observations from before. These are the creeks and rivers that flow downstream into bigger rivers, lakes, ponds, bays, and oceans. Now that we've created our watershed on the land and shown where the water flows, what are some things that humans do that might change or hurt the watershed? What are some things that might cause pollution? For each different thing we think of, we are going to use the red washable marker to color a spot on the land to represent that change. It might be litter from our neighborhoods that goes down storm drains, oil or gas that comes from a car, fertilizers from a farm, chemicals that come from factories, dirt from places that have lost the plants to hold the soil in place, or other kinds of pollution that aren't good for the watershed. Once we have finished marking all the different spots where pollution is coming from in our watershed, Take your second piece of white paper and tape each corner of the land onto the other piece of paper and the table. Now it is time to make it rain again using the spray bottle. What do you think is going to happen to the red marker pollution? Where will the pollution go? What animals might be hurt by pollution in the watershed? As you spray and the rain falls and the water travels across the land, what do you notice? What do you wonder? What does it remind you of? As we watch the pollution travel downstream, we can observe that because the watershed is connected, the things we do in our neighborhoods, at our schools, and right next to the water is all connected too. Because we are all part of a watershed, we need to take care of it. What is something that you can do as a student to keep pollution out of the watershed?